Hello, and welcome to another video. My name is Fleshwat, and today I'm going to be reading another creepypasta story. This story is in light of Valentine's Day, which I know has passed now, but I was very sick and unable to make any content. So, yeah. This story is called The I Love You Murders. I'm here to talk about a topic I've taken interest to lately that never had gotten a lot of media coverage, despite how interesting it is. The I Love You Murders. They were a series of five murders. These took place in a large city in Ohio throughout 1962. The first in the chain of murders took place on January 20th. A woman had been found in an alleyway in the most sketchy part of town. She had been scalped. Not a single strand of her long, dark hair had been left behind. It was definitely a very odd M.O. The cause of death was determined to be a stab wound to the back that pierced right through her heart. The only clue left to go on was a note stuffed into her mouth that read, "I loved her." Since there wasn't anything else to go on, it turned into a cold case. On March 3rd, the next body was found. A woman had been beaten to death and was sprawled out across an old set of railroad tracks not too far from downtown. She had been beaten to death and left very disfigured. She had definitely put up a fight in an attempt to get away. She was missing nails, and her head had been slammed against the tracks several times, leaving her skull cracked. The most disturbing part of this murder is the fact that her crystal blue eyes had been gouged out while she was still alive. There was a note stuffed into her mouth that read, "I loved her," just like the previous murder. In mid-July, a few teenagers had broken into an abandoned house to drink, but their party had been cut short when they found the body of a woman who had been slaughtered in the back room. Her heart had been literally chiseled from her chest, which was also the cause of death. Yet again, the now infamous note had been left in the mouth of the victim. "I loved her." But still, nothing to go on. 4 months later, the police were starting to think the killings had finally died down, but their wishful thinking had been put to an immediate halt when the next victim had been found. Two teenagers had broken into an abandoned factory and found the body of a woman whose face had been carved off. She had also been raped and stabbed several times in the abdomen. She had died from the blood loss, but same as always, nothing but the note was left behind. "I loved her." The fifth and final murder took place on December 1st. This murder wasn't like the others, though. The only things that had been left behind were two green eyes, red hair, a heart, the woman's face, and that same unsettling note. "I loved her." In 2007, the killer was finally found, but not exactly caught. The now old man had been found dead of natural causes in his home. Months later, while his children were clearing out his house in the process to put it on the market, they found an old wardrobe with a padlock on it. Thinking it would be filled with nothing more than guns or paperwork, they carelessly cut the lock. The three of his now fully grown children stood around in awe at what they had found. A perfectly preserved woman. Although it was more like bits and pieces sewn together to make a woman. Taped to the doors on the inside of the wardrobe were pictures that looked to be of their father in his teenage years, with a gorgeous woman of about the same age. She had long dark hair and bright blue eyes, just like the woman in front of them, but it didn't exactly look like the same woman. Some features were close, but not dead on. At closer examination, the words, "I love you," were cut into her lips. And that's the end of this creepypasta. Thank you guys so much for listening. Hope you had a very great Valentine's Day. On one last note, I just want to say that I am very interested in seeing which videos make you guys follow me. So if you weren't a subscriber before this video, but you are now, thank you so much. And make sure to leave a comment down below saying so. Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.